Yeast is a rare cooking ingredient. This ingredient can be found exclusively in the Monarch Bluff region by finding and looting the provision crates. In the whole region you can find 39 such crates, and it is really important to know the location of all of them, considering that it takes on average 30 minutes for them to respawn. The first location is in the upper section of the region. To be precise, on the shores you can find the dagger location you have to explore. That is a pirate wrecked ship. Using the Pure Dog platform, get on board, where you will discover the huge floor hall where you will spot the first supply crate you can loot. The second location is in the same region section, but this time you have to start exploring the traitor's hold slightly below the previous landmark, where you have to check the upper inner section of the area. Here you will find a staircase to get close to the defensive wall. Under the next staircase that leads above the wall, you can find the supply crate you came for. The third location is still in the traitor's hold area, but this time you have to get to the bottom side of the internal area, where you will find the provision stockpile close to the mountain wall. The fourth location is also in the traitor's hold area. This time you need to explore the area close to the locations icon, where you can collect the provision stockpile on the side of the road close to the mountain wall. Continue exploring the previous area. For the fifth location, you need to follow the upper road to the right from the landmark icon, until you get to the crossroad on the map. Here you have to check one side area you can access near the standing torch, where you will find the provision stockpile to collect. The sixth location is still in the same area you started exploring from the second location landmark. This time you have to proceed further to the top right tunnel turn, where after a standing torch you can find the provision crate close to some supply. The seventh location is in the top central side of the region, where you have to use the road from the city going to the right, then up between the mountains. To be precise, you need to check the beginning of the passage, where you will find a watchtower with a pirate flag nearby. You need to get at the last level of the tower in order to find the provision crate you came for. The eighth location is in the top right side of the region, where to the right from the city you will find the mines of Miklot. Here you have to reach the top right buildings. To do so, after you enter the cave system through a tunnel with two red flags on the sides, you have to use the platforms immediately to the left after the passage. With a little bit of parkour, you will reach the top area. Now follow the platforms going to the right, and after climbing the two rocks turn to the left. Now check the crates you will notice on the right in order to find a provision stockpile to loot. The ninth location is still in the mines of Miklot area, but this time you have to explore the bottom right side of it, where you have to parkour on the platforms built along the rocky wall, on top of which you can find the provision crate you came for. The 10th location is also in the mines of Miklot. This time you need to explore the top left side of the area, where you will find a huge building to the left from the locations icon. Get above the platforms and defeat the enemies you can find up here. Then look closer where the enemies were standing in order to find the provision crate you came for. The 11th location is still in the top right side of the region, but this time you need to explore the Adamant mine located below the mines of Miklot explored before. Here you have to check the left side of the road entering inside the location, where you will notice a storage cabin. On the same platform this building is placed, you can find the provision crate to loot. The 12th location is in the top middle of the region, where on the road that is going down on the left from the mines explored before, you have to reach the right side of the second mountain on your pathway, where along the road you can find a building that has the next provision crate to loot. The 13th location is close to the main city of the region, where you have to explore the Krones Rest location to its right. Here you have to check the building on the left from the road going down, inside which under the staircase you can find the provision crate near the window. The 14th location is closer to the center of the region, where you will find the lakeside farm landmark. Here you have to check the main building on the right of the area. Near its entrance you can loot a provision stockpile, but be careful that you will get attacked by a level 21 boss once you will approach the crate. The 15th location is on the right side of the region, where you have to get to one of the small farms on the right side of the road. The one you need to get to is the Fonga family orchard. To be precise, get to the top right side of the structure in the map, in order to find the provision stockpile near some crates. The 16th is still in the right side of the region, but this time you have to explore the campus farm just below the previous explored location. To be precise, you have to find the main building on the top right side of the area. The crate is found on the first floor behind a half wall. The 17th location is in the same the campus farm explored before. But this time you need to reach the small building on the bottom left side of the fence shown in the map. That is a storage building on one side of which you can loot the provision stockpile you came for. The 18th location is also in the campus farm. But now you have to reach the small building on the other fence edge. That is another but smaller storage building, where near a wooden box you can loot the provision crate. The 19th location is the last you can find in the campus farm, which has been explored since the 16th location. Now you have to get to the bottom right side of the area and check another small building attached to the fence. Inside this storage you can find another provision stockpile. The 20th location brings us to the bottom left side of the region, where you will find the Brigand Bastion to explore. Here you have to enter inside the main building of the area, in order to find a provision stockpile on the left side of the oven. For the 21st location you have to continue exploring the previous area. In fact, from the provision stockpile you have to leave the building from the nearby exit, and turn to the left in order to spot immediately the provision crate to loot. The 22nd location is still in the bottom left side of the region, but this time you have to reach the Nautilus of Nunes area, where you have to explore the upper building on the left from the road. That is a small storage inside where you will be able to find and loot a provision stockpile. The 23rd location is also in the Nautilus of Nunes area, where you have to check the opposite side of the road. Here you will find a bridge that you can get above using a staircase on its side. Up there you have to turn to the right and then immediately to the left. This way you can get to an open storage building. And if you check behind it, you will find the next supply crate to loot above some wooden boxes. The 24th location is close to the previous one, but this time you have to get slightly lower in the map, where you will find another platform you can get on top of using a staircase. This will allow you to get inside a storage building that holds the provision crate in the right corner. The 25th is still in the same location, but this time on the left side of the road and close to the location icon. Here you will find a little swamp area with a moss sticking out from the ground. Behind it you can find the provision stockpile you came for near a boat hidden in the grass. The 26th is still in the left side of the region. Below the 4th location you can find two small islands. Well, you have to explore the lower and smaller one, where you will find the provision stockpile near the bonfire. The 27th is still near the same small island, but this time you have to get to its top shore, where near a wrecked sloop you can find and loot another provision stockpile. For the 28th it's time to move to the next western island. To be precise, you have to get to the bottom right shores of it, where a large vessel wreck can be found. On the bottom right side of it you can find the provision crate you came for. Continue exploring the island, you can find the 29th location as well. That is in the middle right side of the island, where you will find a bonfire with a provision stockpile nearby. On the same island can be found also the 13th location, but this time you have to check the top left shores of the island. Here you can find another bonfire close to a shipwreck, that also has the provision crate to loot at its feet. Moving toward the 4th island you can find the 31st location, that is on the water area between the islands, where a half shipwreck can be found. On its left near a sloop you can find the provision crate you came for. The 32nd location brings us to the top left side of the region, where you have to explore the huge island where the fort is built on. Here you have to check the bottom left shores of the island, where you will find a few boulders shown in the map. Near one of them you will find the provision crate you came for. For the 33rd location, you have to move to the bottom right side of the fourth island. To be precise, you have to find the Abadir's Anger area, where you will be able to explore a vessel. Get on board and jump in the hole in the middle of the ship. This will allow you to reach the provision crate hidden here. The 34th location is still in the fourth island. This time you have to check the right shores of it close to a cave landmark, where you can see several boulders in the map. Check between the shipwreck remains in order to find a pirate guarding the provision stockpile you came for. The 35th location is more inland in the fourth island. To be precise, in the brown section above the cave landmark. You can find an abandoned cart here with another provision crate nearby to loot. The 36th location guides us to the top right side of the fourth island, where the Reed Gill fishery landmark can be found. Here you have to check the building all the way to the left and under the road. Outside, nearby a water wheel, you can find the provision crate you came for. For the 37th location, you have to continue exploring the Reed Gill fishery landmark. But this time, you have to check the building on the other side of the road opposite to the previous location. Inside which, under the staircase, you can find the provision stockpile to loot. The 38th location is still in the same landmark location as the previous two. This one will require you to reach the upper edge of the area, where several houses are built above the water. Check the entrance of the first house out of the water in order to find the provision crate. The 39th and the last location is still in the Reed Gill fishery area. But this time you have to check the bottom edge of it, where on one edge of the bridge that connects the buildings, you can find the last provision crate you can loot in this region.